It's a foggy summer morning in Astoria at the mouth of the Columbia River, and the sea lions are fat and happy on the docks as they relax in the warmth of August and wait for their next opportunity to go fishing. Today, we're gonna beat the sea lions out to what's known as the Buoy 10 fishery on the Columbia River for fall Chinook. We're with Doug Hays of Oregon Tackle, who's brought some friends and family out to fish with guide Frank Russum. Doug's not only hoping to catch a Chinook, but to be the first one to catch a Chinook with the new Oregon Tackle Super Teaser, which Doug has been developing for several months. It's had good success with kokanee and coho, but this is the first try for Chinook.
We're gonna put this one down to 25 feet. We're gonna stagger to different depths. 25 worked really good yesterday, but we also got them down to 60, so. It's got a line counter on it, so set it to zero. Well, these are fresh herring. Well, they're coming in a little small this year, so instead of plug cutting them, it makes them even smaller yet. I'm gonna fish these whole. And I got a real simple method to do it. Just take a piece of toothpick or a little brad nail, put it right there, that sews the mouth shut. I got a fixed tie mooching rig here. One's got a 5-aught and a 4-aught. Right about the lateral line of it, running right underneath the dorsal fin there. There's your hook. Now you just get a slight bend and two half hitches. That's a very simple way to rig up a whole bait. They always spin when you do that. It puts that back hook behind the tail where the fish come up, they come up short and grab that. If it hurts anybody, it's Oregon Tackle.
There you go.
Lift that down 25 feet.
How far?
25 feet.
We're starting to get little tide rips here.
You see the current change, a little ripple on the water here, that's from the tide coming in.
We don't have a very big tide, actually a fairly small tide today, so you won't see a lot. But there's times you get about a 3-foot chop in here when the big tides come in, you get an 8, 9, 10 foot tide coming in here. It gets pretty bouncy in here. This is beautiful today though.
So what we got here is your Oregon Tackle Teaser, and all it does is replicate a school of fish falling through the water. We've got a scent chamber right here. So what I'm gonna do is inject that. A little bit of scent in here. We're using the Proke here. You see how that just fills right up? Now that's gonna leach back out over our bait here. And we got our bait fairly in close to this. It's gonna be about a foot and a half. This thing is gonna emulate the bait going after some other fish. So that'll attract the Chinook, hopefully today. We're gonna find out. Drop it down in the water.
There's a lid for you. Okay, it's real important to have this lid so it doesn't tangle up in the attractor right here, so you want to have a shorter lead line than your leader between the swivel and the tractor. Get it too far back, let's tangle in there and make a big mess. You want to reel that one up, Adam, so we can get this one out. Looks like a school of bait fish to me, doesn't it? So lift this one down to 35 feet. We'll have the front one to 25 and the back one to 35. Start catching fish, you start marking a lot of fish, and we'll get all the baits of the depth of fish running.
Welcome back to the mouth of the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. Doug Hays of Oregon Tackle is trying his new Super Teaser on Chinook for the first time, and I'll admit that I was a little skeptical until the one rod with the teaser went off first.
Yeah. So here's our first fish of the day. We've only been trolling for about a half hour. Had that umbrella Oregon Tackle Teaser on there. I like to leave that clicker on because I can hear that thing zing sometimes, yeah. You know what I mean?
I'm gonna let Adam net him, am I right?
Yeah, Adam can net it.
Okay. I'll watch the boat here and don't run anybody over.
Yeah, this is definitely a Chinook. He's took a couple runs and diving down on this. It's where typically your silvers will. They'll dance on the top a little bit. They reel in a little bit easier. They're a smaller fish this time of the year, to where the Chinook are a little bit heavier. I've heard of a 37 and a half come in so far this year. So there's some nice quality fish in here.
Good way to start the morning out. Nice sunny day with fish on, using a brand new tractor system, and working. Let's see what we got here.
Nice little pink clip Chinook. I'm going to bring them right to you, Adam.
Pull some slack off the reel.
I got the reversing head job on that one.
A lot of these are rogue river stock fish going to Young's Bay, and they don't seem to have quite as dark a mouth on them as a lot of the other Chinook.
Yeah.
They have a run of rogue river stock fish to go to Young's Bay specifically for the gillnetters. So they have a terminal fishery there. So what goes through here this time of year, we're fishing on these rogue river stock. They're nice bright fish, not particularly large, but that's what they look like.
So we just released or unhooked this fish here. And there's the rig up we had on there. The scent chamber, we had it full of Pro-Cure. And about a foot and a half back to these hooks. And he smacked it. We've only been fishing for about a half hour.
With these little spinners on here, they actually look like they could be little fish in the water. The big flashers, they do got a lot of color and a lot of pop to them, but they don't look like anything at all in nature. These, even though it doesn't look like a real fish, it does look like movement and little fish moving around.
Like a school of fish going
through. Like a school of fish.
Yeah,
it's awesome. I'm impressed.
Okay, who wants this fish? Let's just get on that fish.
Feel the other rod, though.
Jumping out.
Oh.
Caught the little jack.
Is it?
Oh.
The feline just get it or what?
I don't know.
If that's a jack,
I don't know, maybe. He pulled me there.
Whoa!
Whoa. Alright, pull up, walk back.
Don't back up, lift the rod higher. Don't hold the rod that way. Don't hold the rod that way. That's how you break a rod. There you go. Lift up from right there. There you go.
Bring walk backwards. Back.
Don't rock what? Don't walk back, just lift up. Stay close to the edge of the boat. That's the way to get close to the edge of the boat. There you go. You walk back, you pull the fish underneath the boat. Gotta bring him up. There you go. Pull some slack off the reel here. Watch the front. Wow.
A jack.
Yeah, jack.
Watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that this show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.